One of the most anticipated albums to me this year was Pattern Seeking Animals' Prehensile Tales. I'm a big fan of Spock's beard, so if anything that Spock's beard's DNA is a part of, whether it's this, anything to do with Neil Morris, Transatlantic, etc., I'm guaranteed to love. How does this stack up against its debut album? Come back and we'll find out. Beard side project Pattern Seeking Animals is back with their second album, Prehensile Tales, which is hot on the heels of their self-titled debut that was released last year. The band consists of current Spock's Beards members Ted Leonard and Dave Meros, the band's former drummer Jimmy Keegan, and their main songwriter John Boegehold on keyboards. Much like their debut album, the Spock's DNA is all over Prehensile Tales. However, the band sounds more cohesive and they have taken even more chances on this album. The album opener, Raining Hard in Heaven, immediately reminds me of a Roxy Music song called Love is a Drug, which is off their album Siren. Raining Hard in Heaven features excellent melody lines, typically great vocals along with some vintage keys make this a favorite of mine from the album. The track is alone is even better than anything on the first album. Not a knock on that album, but rather this shows that Pattern Seeking Animals has grown a lot in a very short period of time. It's really that good. Here Is My Autumn was the first track released as a single from Prehensile Tales, another interesting track with its own sound. That's what I really love about this band. The songs get their own identity, and it's not just the words and music, but the arrangements. Also, to those of you who don't know, Ted Leonard is a damn good guitarist. Check the solo on this song. In my opinion, Dave Meros is one of the most underrated bassists on the planet. This whole second album is a showcase for how good he is. The track Elegant Vampires has another killer bass line from him. I'll probably say this later, but this band knows and understands how to arrange a song to get the most out of it. After Elegant Vampires, we have a song called Why Don't We Run, and it is yet another interesting song. And by interesting, I mean it's probably the weakest song on the album and doesn't really do anything for me. After Why Don't We Run, we have Lifeboat, and this is the first of the two epics on the album, and it's over 17 minutes long. The chorus on this song is very memorable, which is very important, but because it is an epic, it sometimes feels longer than it needs to be. Don't get me wrong, I love the horns used in this section that starts off the first 5 minutes, but it does somewhat continue on and on too long. However, that does not stop Ted Leonard from playing a great guitar solo, and of course, his vocals on this album as a whole are just as amazing as usual. Now we arrive at the last song and probably my favorite on the album, Soon But Not Today. This rounds out the album and clocks in over 12 minutes long. Soon But Not Today sounds very much apart from what the band has done, and this is a great example of why Pattern Seeking Animals exists. When 12 minutes can have so much going on and never lose a listener, that's a pretty good damn song. Honestly, I had very high expectations for Pattern Seeking Animals' second album from the start because I love all the incarnations of Spock's beard. While I did really enjoy their self-titled album, it is as good as anything that Spock's has done, and I'll say it, Prehensile Tales is a must for fans of Spock's beard, but it's more than that. It's a must for anyone that thinks prog rock's best days are behind them. And as a final rating for this album, I give an 83%. This would make a good addition to anybody's prog rock collection, though not essential. Thanks for your time, guys. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye. All right, guys, welcome back. I'll quickly show off the album here. That, of course, is the cover. I like that artwork. It's kind of neat. Different, that's for sure. And there's the back, the track listing. Let's see it there. And of course it's a gatefold, so we'll open that up and you can see the pictures here and the lyrics and credits on that side. And as always, Inside Out always puts a bonus CD of the album, which I think is a nice touch. So there it is too, you know, I can listen to it in the truck on the way to work and back, or around the house, take it up to the lake, whatever. Class act, Inside Out. Great album. Guys, you picked this up on my recommendation. You won't be disappointed. Thanks again, guys. We'll talk to you, and I'll see you in the next review. Night.